Hello and welcome. We are so happy to have you here tonight. My name is Jay and I'm your StriveScan facilitator, and we are here on behalf of the Texas Association for College Admission Counseling Virtual College Fair. It is a wonderful night to be here. We have some great schools here that are joining us, and just a couple of housekeeping items that I have for you. So, first off, there is a Q&A button at the bottom of your screen. If you have any questions for anyone at any time, feel free to type those in there and our panelists can see and reply back to you. But don't worry, we cannot see or hear you. Your camera and video our camera and audio are completely off, so you're all good there. You can see us, but we cannot see you. This is just one of many sessions. So we would love to invite you to sign up for additional sessions, learn more about additional schools on top of these six great ones you're going to learn about tonight. And this presentation is being recorded and will be available in about a week at the same place that you registered, strivescan.com/Texas. Now I'm gonna stop sharing my screen and I'm gonna bring on our first presenter here, Bowdoin College. Go ahead and take us away.
All right, let's jump right in. Hello, everyone. My name is Kyra Green. I'm an Assistant Dean of Admissions at Bowdoin. Excited to chat with you about our school today. So we are a small private liberal arts institution located on the coast of Maine, about a 20-minute drive from the ocean, right in Brunswick. Our total student body is about 2,000 students, meaning each incoming class is about 500 each. Our largest majors, no particular order, are environmental studies, given our location, alongside government and legal studies, math, English, and econ. We are a place that is really connected to our location. So what does that mean? I would say we get a lot of our core values from our home state. Maine is a place that's very welcoming. It's a place where people are very humble, independent, hardworking. And so we try to look for that in our students as well. So given where we're located, we are in Brunswick, but I promise you there's more to do than you'd imagine. We have about 60 restaurants surrounding the college community. There's a bowling alley, there's an escape room, there's a TJ Maxx, which is important to me. There's a Target and Walmart, 10 minutes in either direction. So in my mind, that makes us a city. And there's also an Amtrak station and a bus station, about a 10-minute walk from campus. So if you are itching to get far away, you can go to Boston for about $20 and it's about a 2-hour bus ride. We're also 30 minutes from Portland, Maine, which is the biggest city in Maine. It can best be described as a really artistic community. And this also means that we are close to the Jetport, which makes it really easy for students to get to us from around the country and around the world. In addition to our on-campus community, we also have a few other facilities. The first is the Schiller Coastal Studies Center, which really focuses on environmental studies, marine science, earth and oceanographic studies. So it's a place where students can really collaborate with faculty and do some of that research. And then we have another facility on Kent Island in the Bay of Fundy in Canada, where students can do research of their choosing for 10 weeks over the summer and be paid for that work. Beyond that connection to the ocean, that connection to the environment, there's also a ton to do that doesn't involve hiking boots or a life jacket. So some of these things are spring concert series. We have athletics at 3 different levels. We bring a ton of speakers, I'm a ton of performers, so there's a lot to do always. And if for some reason you don't find something of interest, you can always create your own opportunities with funding from the college. So let's talk a bit about who we are at our core. We're founded with this notion of the common good, meaning that your Bowdoin education shouldn't just be used for personal gain, but should be shared with others. And that's still something that's really important to us today. With that in mind, we attract students who view life and view issues as us against a problem, as opposed to us against one another. With that collaborative community on campus, this means that faculty are also involved in that. They come to Bowdoin because they want to work closely with students, want to be available and accessible to you. Faculty members only teach 2 classes per semester, meaning that they are very much ready to collaborate with you. They're very much ready to chat with you about classes, but also about your home life, your adjustment to college, and just form those meaningful relationships with you. So I spoke a bit about the common good. So what does that mean for life after Bowdoin? Of course, some people will go into nonprofit work in healthcare and education and service. That's certainly a big part of what students do. but they also go into life in the for-profit world. A lot of Bowdoin alums have founded or sit on the boards of or work for some of the most influential companies in the world. For example, the founder of Netflix attended Bowdoin and has found a way to really think about the common good in a way that fits for him. So he's really big on educational justice, educational equity. And so that's a place where he does a lot of philanthropy using his revenue from Netflix to really give back. If you're not ready for the for-profit world or nonprofit world, you may go to graduate school straight out from Bowdoin. And these are just some schools where the largest number of alums are attending. So with all of this in mind, what do we look for? Grades and heart. I know that sounds simple, but it's true. We are a place that's hard and challenging. And so of course we want students who are up to the challenge, but we also want students who are kind, and that's really important to us. What we're not looking for is income. We are need blind for all domestic students, permanent residents, and DACA and undocumented students, meaning that your decision to apply for aid doesn't impact our decision to admit you. We're also a school that meets full demonstrated need for our students, and we also do this without any loans in your aid package. We're also not looking for test scores. We were the first school to go test optional over 50 years ago, so we've had a lot of time to really hone our process and get a sense of your academic prep by using things such as your transcript, letters of recommendation, and your writing. And we will not hold it against you should you choose to withhold your test scores. So I'll leave you with this, our offer of the college written by our seventh president. It is our promise to our students and what we hope you get out of your 4 years at Bowdoin. So if anything I said today resonated with you or sparked your interest, feel free to drop some questions in the Q&A box. Thank you for listening.
Thank you so much, Kyra. Really appreciated that presentation here. We are going to move right along to our second presenter of the evening, Maine Maritime Academy. Go ahead and take it away, Brandon. Oop, we cannot hear you.
We're good. All right. Hello and welcome to Maine Maritime Academy. My name is Brandon. I'm an admissions counselor here. This presentation will give you a taste of what we have to offer here at the Academy. And if you have any further questions, do feel free to jump in on the question and answer sessions with one of us on the admissions team. What is Maine Maritime Academy? Maine Maritime Academy is a school providing an exceptional education within the maritime thread. If you have any interest in maritime studies, be it from operating vessels to ocean studies to the movement of goods, you have come to the right place. We're a small school that has just under 1,000 students in our 23 degree programs, meaning that your classes are small and super hands-on. On top of that, we offer professional licenses from engineering to deck licenses if you desire to work out at sea one day. Our students are engaged with all that we have to offer with over 30 organizations and clubs to 15 different maritime, different varsity sports. What stands Maine Maritime Academy apart from any other school is our access to the waterfront campus, providing students with over 60 vessels, from training vessels to research vessels to pleasure vessels and everything in between. If you would like to be on the water, you have found the best playground you can imagine. MMA offers 3 degrees, associates, bachelor's, and master's, and over 23 degree programs in 4 different schools of study: engineering, transportation, management, and ocean science. In addition, students from our engineering and transportation programs may receive professional licenses that allow them to sail as engineers and deck officers in the shipping industry. A critical component to Maine Maritime Academy's education is the hands-on experiential learning that our students receive, whether it be in the labs or through their summer field experience. Students are put in decision-making positions that are going to test their knowledge and ability to provide them with a unique opportunity that is uncommon in the traditional educational setting. This is just a small list of our simulators and labs that our students get to experience during their time here at Maine Maritime. A common misconception about the Maritime Academy education is that our students are in some way obligated to complete military service after graduation. Unlike federal service academies like Army, Navy, Air Force, Merchant Marine, and U.S. Coast Guard, only some of our students wear a uniform at MMA, and none of our graduates, except those who are electing to pursue military service opportunities, are required to serve. What you will see, though, at MMA is called our Regiment of Midshipmen. Nearly two-thirds of our students populate the regiment, which these students are required to participate in this training program due to their nature of the U.S. Coast Guard unlimited license degree requirements. Any student, though, may elect to participate only unlimited students are required to be part of the regimen. If this sounds intimidating, believe me, it's not. Just like nearly every other college and university in the country, we do have independent students that gain traditional college experience. Take it from me. We're not all work and no play here. Our students do enjoy themselves by participating in clubs, teams, and a variety of student-run organizations. There's something for everybody to do here at MMA. If we don't have what you're looking for, we want to help you develop into a leader and give you a chance to create it. As our slogan goes, we are all Mariners. The real value of Maine Maritime Academy's education can be understood through job opportunities and career outcomes of our alumni network. This is accomplished through the career industry training that they gain through their summer internships, their co-ops, and getting to sail aboard our own 500-foot training vessel, which you see in the bottom left of your screen, and as well as the state of Maine, I mean the 88-foot schooner Bowdoin for the summer. Over 90% of our students are employed within 90 days of graduation, but quite possibly the most impressive stat about MMA is the financial return from the investment on our students' education. Beginning in Castine, Maine, these are just a few examples of the types of career destinations that take our alumni quite literally and anywhere and everywhere in the world. Now, finally, I want to take a quick look at some 2020 and 2021 accolades on MMA and how we compare. According to Money Magazine, Maine Maritime Academy is the number one ranked college for veterans, the number two most transformative college. And according to the US News and World Report, Maine Maritime Academy is the number three ranked public school, number four ranked regional college north, and number 10 best value school. I hope you enjoyed what you have heard about Maine Maritime Academy. And if you have any further questions, please don't hesitate to jump on one of the live Q&A session, and I will be there to answer for you.
Awesome. Thank you so much. Really appreciate your time, Maine Maritime Academy. We are going to our third school of the evening, Merrimack College. Are you ready?
Yes, I am ready. Good afternoon, everybody. Just give me 1 second here while I get my slideshow up and running. Awesome. So good afternoon. Good evening. My name is Doughty Torres. I'm one of the assistant directors of admissions here at Merrimack. And I wanna thank you all so much for taking the time out of your busy schedules to speak with me and kind of learn about all these amazing schools that are here today. So I'm gonna take a couple of your minutes just to kind of talk more about Merrimack and give you just an idea of what Merrimack is and everything that we have to offer for our students. So Merrimack College, our total enrollment is around 3,800. With graduate students, we're hovering a little bit over close to 5,000 students. Our average classroom size is 21. Student to faculty ratio is 15-1. So with us, students get the best of both worlds because we're big enough that there's a lot to do, but we're small enough that you're going to get more of that personalized attention in the classroom. Our students come from over 30 countries and about 30 different states. So we are truly becoming a global powerhouse in the sense that we have students that come from all over the globe. And that's the beautiful thing about coming to a school like Merrimack is that you're going to have all these different type of student populations on our campus. Until about 2 years ago, we were about 50-50, which was very interesting. Until about 2 years ago, a lot of people were asking what happened with the female to male ratio. One of the biggest things is as we're growing as an institution, we've added more programs. So 2 years ago, we added nursing, and we keep on adding more programs, again, seeing what's out there and what is it that our students want to do. So as you can see here, our most popular programs, we have over 100 different academic majors to choose from. So there's a variety of options depending on what students ultimately want to do. Business is our most popular major. So about 32% of our students are involved in business. However, there's a variety of concentrations within all of our programs. I always like to use my personal example because it kind of gives students an idea of what it is to come to a school like Merrimack. So when I started, I thought I wanted to become a doctor. You know, clearly that didn't work out, but I'm a firm believer that once you go to college, you're supposed to love what you do. So I did the bio and the chem, didn't like that. Then eventually I ended up doing business and ended up loving that. So eventually I ended up double majoring in international business and sociology. But again, that was my major. That's what I decided to do. And again, coming to a school like Merrimack is going to allow you to do those type of things. Also within our location, you know, we are located about 30 miles north of Boston. So again, it allows students to keep that small atmosphere on our campus, but also at the same time, have direct access to the big city of Boston. With us, excuse me, at Merrimack, we're very career focused. So what do I mean by being career focused? Yes, it's important that you're in the classroom, that you're learning the materials, that you're out there, that you're learning all the different terminologies, that you're learning all these different research methods. But for what us is important is that you get that real world of experience under your belt, that you're making that connection so that you're out there, that you're getting that real world of experience. So about 86% of our students will do some form of co-op or internship. The other 14% will do some form of research opportunity with our faculty members. So yes, if you want to go that route where you're going into the real world, you could definitely get that experience. But if you want to do more of that research base, you could also do that. So for example, for students that want to go into medical school, law school, dental school. And as we grow, we keep on adding more different academic programs. For example, last year alone, this year we've added economics, neuroscience, data science. So every single year we're looking to see what is it that students want to do. And we keep on adding those more of those programs and giving students that those different research opportunities. I'll give you a perfect example. Last year with me, I do a lot of our international recruiting as well. So one of the biggest things that I do is that I travel a lot internationally. So one of the research that our students were going to do was how sleeping patterns affected your different time zones. So that was something that our students were able to do. But again, that was something that they were able to do within that program. And with having, 20 students interested in biology, at the end of the day, every single one of them is going to do something completely different. So with us, what's important is that to make sure that they get that real world of experience outside the classroom so that they're successful at the end of their day. With us, how do you apply? Our application process is a very simple process. So we are on the Common App and we have our own application. So either or whichever one students decide to fill out, it's completely fine. With us, we do require high school transcripts, letters of recommendation, and all those things. With us, our application is also completely free. So it doesn't cost students anything to apply to our institution. So with us, we always advise students, if you are interested in applying to Merrimack, definitely take advantage of all these different opportunities, because with us, we are test optional. So we're giving students an opportunity to make sure they want to see what the process is for Merrimack, that they're able to go through the whole process. We do have early decision, early action, and then regular decision. So we advise students whenever they feel comfortable in applying, definitely have those conversations with your guidance counselor, with your teachers, and figure out which is the best time for you to apply to our institution. One of the biggest things with our population and our students is that all of our students qualify for some form of merit scholarship. So about 99% of our incoming class will receive some form of grant or scholarship from us. So for example, tuition and fees is over $40,000 a year, or about $46,000 a year. So on average, students pay about $20,000. Some students pay more, some pay less. Again, it all depends on your financial, on the financial background, as well as the academic fees. So we'll look at all that information. And then based on that information, you'll get some form of merit scholarship. And last year that was equivalent to about $80 million. So we are very generous with our financial aid. But I always encourage students to definitely apply for our institution. With us, we only require the FAFSA form, which is great for us. But again, it allows students to kind of go through that whole process as well too. And that's basically it. That's my spiel. As you can see here, there's a picture of our beautiful campus. So thank you.
Awesome. Thank you so much, Dowry. Really appreciate that here. We are gonna move along on over to Simmons University. Go ahead and take it away from us, Mia.
Wait, just one moment to unmute myself. But hi, everyone. My name is Mia Zilahi. I use she, her pronouns, and I am one of our admission counselors here at Simmons University. I appreciate you spending some time this afternoon or evening, also making the same mistake, to learn a little bit more about Simmons. So to give you just a basis, we're a small women-centered institution right in the center of Boston, Massachusetts. We have about 1,800 undergraduates on our campus. But before we delve into exactly all that we have to offer in terms of academics, internships, opportunities, and just Boston in general, I wanted to give you a little bit of a history lesson of who we are and how Simmons was founded. Going back to around 1899, we were founded by a man of the name of John Simmons. He was an affluent Bostonian who was actually the first one to come up with what is now known as tailored sizes and ready-made suits. And through his, industry and becoming quite wealthy, he realized it was really the women in his life that were backing him both professionally and personally. So it was his main mission back then to form an institution that would allow women to have an independent livelihood. We were never at any point known as what might be considered a finishing school. It was really our main mission to pair a liberal arts education with professional preparation. And that's something that over the past century has certainly evolved and changed as the times have. We now consider ourselves a women-centered institution just to be more inclusive of transgender and non-binary and non-cis identifying folks on our campus. And so that has really evolved and shifted our language and definition as an institution, but still holding those true core values at heart today and seeing how that's evolved over our 60 plus programs and organizations and institutions at Simmons. Speak a little bit about where we are within Boston, Massachusetts. For those of you who are a little less familiar, we're right within the Fenway neighborhood, or what is known as the Longwood Medical Area. For anybody who's interested in pre-health or nursing positions, Longwood is really the epicenter of medicine in the country, if not the world. So there's certainly tons of opportunities in terms of internships, co-ops, things of that nature. But beyond that, you are just encompassed by a city full of students. They do say one in four people you run into who just on the streets of Boston will be an undergraduate student, which isn't something I had fully understood until moving to Boston myself, what an emphasis there is on education here, but also an emphasis on culture and getting out there. And we really do want to make Simmons feel like your home within Boston, to get really ingrained within the community, to get to know the city, feel comfortable hopping on the T, which is our subway system here in Boston. We're right on top of three major T stops. So if you're interested in checking out pastries in the North End or going down to the Boston Aquarium, taking access of the Museum of Fine Arts, the Isabel Gardner Stewart Museum, which is right next door to us. We want you to feel that Boston is your home, Boston's your playground, and you're part of a larger community at whole. And then you really come back to that central hub of Simmons, that 1800 undergraduate students, where your professors will get to know you, they will know you by name. Our student to faculty ratio is right around 8-1. So you have this tight-knit community among a much larger city as your background. And to speak to those 60 majors and programs we have at Simmons, I do like to point out that, you know, anything that you view on the screen that is listed as a major, you can always turn into a minor. The minors are just separated often that way. But to name some of our more popular programs, this is by no means in order. We are certainly most known for our STEM fields at Simmons. I think being a women-centered institution really has that strong footing and grounding in the STEM sciences, starting off with nursing, physical therapy, neuroscience has been very large. We also have the oldest social work program in the New England area, data science and business and marketing, just to name a few. The other things I like to highlight on this page are just our accelerated programs that sit on the right-hand side. So anyone interested in pursuing a graduate degree while they're completing their undergrad, these are certainly things to take a look at, as well as offering pre-medical, pre-law advising, and pre-med also encompasses much more than just medical school, kind of delving right into dentistry, medicine, optometry, podiatry, and even veterinary science, if that's something you're interested in. So we do have situated pathways for students who are interested in pursuing graduate work after their time at Simmons or even at their time at Simmons. So like I mentioned a little bit earlier, we do really place an emphasis on professional preparation throughout your time here, and that can be encompassed in many different forms, whether that be an internship or research opportunity, a senior thesis, or clinical and field work, dependent on what you're interested in. But every single student who comes through Simmons will have that opportunity built into their curriculum right along their time. And so, as I think you can tell, hopefully, I'm quite passionate about speaking about a women-centered experience in education. And it's something that we do really hope melds your experience here at Simmons and really what it will have you become throughout our curriculum and different experiences, both academically and extracurricularly here, that you'll walk away from your time at Simmons being a fierce advocate, a leader within your field, and somebody who is quite ready to work. I will say there's quite a few statistics on here to speak to the women-centered experience, but I think one thing that really shows how Simmons does this and does this well has to do with just that about 91% of our students right after their time of graduation are either employed within a graduate program, but beyond that, 96% of that 91 students are within a field related to what they studied. So what you're learning here, you will become emboldened and impassioned in what you're learning, that you really do have the skills and tactical knowledge that it takes to become a leader and an influence in whatever it is you're most interested in pursuing. And so that has all that we have to offer here at Simmons. Like all of our colleagues have said before, any questions you have, please feel free to drop them in the chat box and look forward to connecting you all soon.
Awesome. Thank you so much. Really appreciate that presentation here. And we're going to move on to Suffolk University. Go ahead and take it away for us.
Awesome. Thank you so much. I'm going to get my screen up here. All right. Well, good evening, everyone. Thank you so much for tuning in to tonight's presentations. My name is Ellie Veal Wilson, and I'm Assistant Director of Undergraduate Admission at Suffolk University. A little bit about Suffolk. First, we are located in the wonderful city of Boston, Massachusetts. Boston is actually ranked the number one student city in the United States with over 250,000 students calling it home. So definitely a great city for anything higher education related, as well as just opportunities after graduation for graduate school or jobs. With regard to Suffolk specifically, we are located right in the heart of downtown Boston, and our location itself adds so much value to our students' experience, both academically and socially, because they're really immersed within a culture of arts, entertainment, dining, internships, and real world work experience. So we are more of that kind of urban institution, but our location itself adds a ton of value to our students' experience while they're with us. A little bit more about kind of the makeup of our university and the size. We have just under 5,000 undergraduate students, so we are considered a medium-sized university. And we have students that come to Suffolk from all over the United States, from around 46 states to be exact, as well as 94 countries. And 20% of our undergraduate population is international students. So you're going to have the opportunity to interact with students from all different backgrounds, cultures, and walks of life. And that is something that we really value at Suffolk and makes sense given our location in the city and the fact that Boston is such a multicultural and diverse city within itself. In terms of our class sizes and kind of academic makeup, we have around 70 undergraduate programs housed between two colleges, our College of Arts and Science and our Sawyer Business School. We also have a law school on our campus. And our average class size is just at 21 students. So your classes are going to be small, which is nice as a student because it allows you to really get to know your classmates and your professors. And your professor not only will know your name, but they'll know your interests, hobbies, passions, things that you're involved in outside of the classroom, and that creates a very supportive academic learning environment. In terms of some of our most popular majors, and these are not in any specific order, biology is extremely popular. We have multiple concentrations within that. Criminal justice, journalism, law, political science, psychology, sociology, and then in terms of business, some of the most popular programs are going to be accounting, finance, entrepreneurship, marketing, management, and global business. So moving on to talk a little bit kind of more about our educational philosophy and ethos at Suffolk, we are very much grounded in the idea of experiential learning, which essentially means learning by doing. And it's really taking you outside the classroom where you are having the opportunity to interact with professionals within the field that you're studying and gain those important skills within your area of expertise that you're studying, but also just skills like teamwork and communication, adaptability that are going to make you stand out in the job market. So it is very common for our students to do internships. And one of the great things about being in a city is that internships are everywhere. So many of our internship locations are our neighbors. So they know who Suffolk is, they know who our students are. And it makes internships and those types of real world practical experiences for our students extremely accessible. As I mentioned, we have that experiential learning approach, developing your soft skills and helping you also gain that global perspective so you can go out and be contributing member of society and also know how to interact with all different kinds of people. We also have so many different ways that you can get involved on campus. We have over 100 plus student clubs and organizations so you can explore your interests and passions outside of the classroom. And then we're also really focused on opening up the world for you and finding ways for you to explore different countries and cultures. We have around 50 different partnerships for study abroad locations all throughout the world. But one thing that's really cool about Suffolk is that we have our own campus in Madrid, Spain, Suffolk University Madrid. And there are a lot of different ways that you can experience that Spain campus. First, you can actually start your freshman year of college in Spain and stay up to 2 years for most majors. We also offer traditional study abroad programs to our Spain campus as well, if that's a little bit more of your speed. And then finally, the application process. So we have a very holistic approach to admission, meaning that essentially we're trying to get a strong sense of who you are as an individual and as a student. We are on the Common App, but we also have our own institutional app. So it's whichever one you decide that you would like to submit to us. We also ask for your high school transcript to get a feel for what your academic journey has been like, one letter of recommendation that can come from a counselor or a teacher, as well as your essay. We are a test optional institution, so that gives you the power to determine if you would like to submit a test score or not. And that's something that really connects deeply to our mission of access and opportunity. And then finally, we do offer merit scholarships as well as need-based aid at Suffolk. For merit scholarships, you actually don't have to apply for those opportunities. You are automatically considered at the time that you submit your application for admission. So it's kind of nice, no additional steps or anything that you have to do on your end. We will automatically consider you for those opportunities. And then we also have need-based financial aid. For that, just make sure you fill out the FAFSA. And if you have any other questions, please let me know in the Q&A. Thank you.
Awesome. Thank you so much for that. Really appreciate your time here, Ellie. We are going to move along on over to our last presenter. And let's get that screen stop shared. Beautiful. All right, and University of Maine at Machias, you are here and ready. Let's go for it.
Hi, everybody. Thank you for coming tonight. My name is Dorsey Hill. I am an admissions counselor for the University of Maine at Machias. So to start off, here are some beautiful pictures of our campus. So as far as where the University of Maine at Machias is, we are located on the down east coast of Maine. We are located in a beautiful rural area, so we are not city centered at all. We are right on the coast, so we're 15 minutes from multiple different beautiful beaches. We have lots of wilderness behind our campus. So we are right in the sweet spot for those of you who like hunting, fishing, swimming, just really getting out into the outdoors. We are about an hour south of New Brunswick, but we're also about 2 hours from Orono and Bangor, and about 4 hours north of Portland, a 6 hour drive from Boston. So just some fun facts about UMM. We have about 750 students total, which makes us an incredibly small university, but that gives us the opportunity to really get to know our students and be incredibly hands-on from day one. Our average class size is about 13, and even in a non-COVID year, our classes typically cap out around 25, so you won't be in a lecture hall with hundreds of people. You will be in a small classroom setting, really getting a personalized education. Our professors really get to know you, what you want to study, and really get to know what you want to do for a career so they can match you with different internships, grad school opportunities, and job opportunities. We have 243 acres of wilderness behind our campus, so we really take advantage of that. A lot of our programs will use that to their advantage. So we have trails behind campus, and a lot of our recreation and tourism management students will go keep the trails back there. We do tree surveys for some of our botany courses. We have been voted one of the top 30 LGBTQ plus campuses in the United States, thanks to the Campus Pride Index. We are a very welcoming small community. We typically, in a non-COVID year, will host the Rainbow Ball, which is a prom for high school students who don't feel comfortable at their own proms. And we do offer different resources for LGBTQ plus students. 99% of our students get some form of financial aid, which is amazing. We're an incredibly affordable school, and I'll get into that in a little bit later. We have a lot of 4-in-1 master's programs, thanks to being a regional campus for the University of Maine flagship in Orono. So with a lot of our programs, you can get your bachelor's done in 4 years here and then get your master's done in just a year at the University of Maine flagship campus in Orono. We can also take advantage of the over 407 opportunities for study abroad via the flagship campus. So we have had students who have studied all over the world in some amazing programs. We're also ranked one of the top socially mobile universities. So that basically means that no matter what your background is and where you come from, you have the same opportunity at success. Everybody has the same starting point, and we really want to make sure that everyone feels welcome and accepted in our campus community. So some of our most popular majors on campus are marine biology, psychology, conservation law, education, and wildlife biology. But we have many, many more. And we pride ourselves on being hands-on from day one. You're not just going to be sitting in a lecture hall, you know, looking off of PowerPoints, reading out of a book. You will be getting hands-on experience and real-world experience that way when you go for a job or go to apply to grad school or all these internships. You have the experience and not just a degree. So as an example, if you are a marine biology student, within the first week, you are out on the mudflats, out on the beach doing crab surveying, or out on a whale watch. So we really pride ourselves with all of our local community partners. We have the Down East Institute, which is a marine research field station. We also work a lot with the Next Step Domestic Violence Program within our psychology program. We really take advantage of our local opportunities. And as you can see, these are some amazing pictures here of our students out in the field. So this is one of our wildlife biology classes. We work with the Maine State Bear Tagging Team. So our students will go out and do den surveys. So they will go out with the bear tagging team. They will tranquilize the animals humanely, and then they will weigh them, measure them, and just get all these cool measurements from them. We also, I have a picture from our conservation law courses. We work with the Maine wardens. If you've ever seen that show, Northwoods Law, some of the wardens from that show are graduates of UMM, and they will take students on warden ride-alongs. So they get to see a day in the life of a warden. They do mock crime scenes. And then the last photo is of some of our students out whitewater rafting. So we have quite a few merit scholarships for our out-of-state students. And we are test optional, but we can base our merit scholarships off of your SAT scores. We will go with whichever is highest. So say you don't get to take the SATs or ACTs, but you have a really high GPA, we will honor that GPA's scholarship. But also if you don't have quite the highest GPA, but you absolutely rock the ACTs or SATs, we will honor whichever one is highest. We are also need blind, so your financial status will not affect your scholarships that you get. And the average out-of-state student pays between $7,000 and $8,000 per year. This is after financial aid being taken off, so make sure to fill out the FAFSA, and also after our merit scholarships. And these don't require an extra application. We do have some other scholarships that you can apply for, including our first-gen student scholarship or our Krauss Memorial Marine Bio Scholarship. So here's some of the information on our university. So it is free to apply, and we are rolling admissions, so we don't have a hard deadline. So if you are, you know, a little late to the game, that's totally fine. We'll absolutely take your application. And here is my info as well. Feel free to reach out if you have any sort of questions, and we are also able to do in-person on-campus tours or virtual tours.
Beautiful, thank you so much. Really appreciate that here. I'm gonna go ahead and ask all of my panelists to bring their video and so forth back on, because I've got a question for everyone here. All right, let me see. Beautiful. So what advice would you give someone going through the college search process? Bowden, what do you have to say about that?
I would definitely encourage students to just be themselves. And remember, at the end of the day, this process is about them. Yes, ask for advice from your college counselor, from teachers, from friends, from family. But at the end of the day, you are the one going to this place and living there for the next 4 years, potentially. And so be true to who you are, because that's what we want to see in the process.
Beautiful. Awesome. And Maine Maritime Academy, what do you have for us?
Yeah, I think it's the coach coming out of me, but it's visit as many schools as possible. I know it's hard in this day and age, but really get to know what those schools are about, how they are invested in you, understand the importance of their alumni and their alumni network. But don't be afraid to ask questions. I mean, every question is an important question to you in the process. So that would be my three bullet points there.
Awesome, thanks for that. Merrimack College, do you have anything to add?
Yes. So I would say definitely now one of the biggest advantage I would say is definitely utilize your resources that are available for you. I know that COVID this year has been something that has affected all of us globally. So one of the biggest things that has come out of this is all the virtual options that all schools have. So allowing us to do these virtual webinars, you know, you're now allowed to do virtual visits, sitting in a classroom. And again, with having all these resources available for you, you could be from anywhere in the world and you'll still be able to see those college campuses. So I will definitely say that if you definitely have the opportunity, take advantage of all these things that are available for you at this time.
Awesome. Great advice there. Simmons University, what do you have to say about this?
Absolutely. I would echo everyone's message of being true to themselves, but also throughout this process, don't be afraid to define your own non-negotiables. Figure out exactly what it is you're searching for from an institution and what you need throughout this college process. And don't be afraid to ask. You will have an admission counselor at every school you apply to, and we really are here to help you along the process. So just defining what it is for you, and also just like Bowden said, being true to you.
Great, beautiful. And Suffolk University?
Yeah, I would say one piece of advice I always give students is to really make sure that especially once you've decided which schools you're applying to, or you've kind of created your list, to make sure when you're applying that you proofread. I know it sounds like a simple thing or common sense, but I can't tell you how many times I've read over applications or essays, and you can tell the student has just hit the submit button and hasn't read it over. And remember, sometimes this is, you know, the first time we are seeing your name on a paper, interacting with you. So just keep that in mind to give put your best foot forward. And remember, this might be your first interaction with us on the admission side.
Awesome. Great advice there. And let's close it out with University of Maine at Machias. What advice do you have to give?
My big advice would be, don't be afraid to ask questions. It's better to go away with more info than not enough info, and there really aren't any stupid questions. We have heard it all, so I would much rather have a student ask 50 million questions and go away feeling a lot less stressed out than not want to ask questions and be super stressed. We're here, that's our job, is to help make this as stress-free as possible.
Beautiful, beautiful. Well, that's going to wrap us up for the evening here. Ask your questions, reach out to anyone. All of this is great advice. We've had 6 great presentations here. So I just want to take a moment to thank all of our panelists, all of our attendees who are here live or watching recorded. We're so grateful that you've been a part of us here today. When you close this window, we just want to let you know that there will be a short 4-question survey. We would appreciate and love any feedback that you can provide, because we always want to do better as well. And this is just one of many sessions being recorded. So you can absolutely sign up for more sessions to learn about more great schools on top of these 6 we've learned about tonight. And in about a week, you'll find out about this session's recording. So if you've missed anything or you need to go back and rewatch something, strivescan.com/Texas. All right, everyone, have a great night.